First thing you want to do is shut off the main water supply to the dishwasher. Next step is to remove the kick plate to get at the water supply line and the drain line. Now to remove the drain line. Next step, remove the water supply line, but use the correct wrench. My home toolkit didn't have the right size wrench, so I just used needle nose pliers. I had a better set of open end wrenches, but they're in the shed and I didn't want to have to dig the snow away from the door. After removing the mounting screws from under the countertop, pull the unit out and unplug it. To remove the upper basket, simply pop out the retaining clips at the ends of the railings. The lower basket, you can just lift it right out. Pop out the lower wash arm with the screwdriver. Comes out easy. Then simply lift out the coarse drain tray. It's got a handle. Next, remove the lower spray arm support. You just turn it 90 degrees and lift it off. Pull out the main filter by just lifting it out. Next, unscrew the pump cover. Remove the check ball valve and set it aside. Unplug the power supply line from the circulation pump. Then remove the two screws that hold the circulation pump's retaining clip in place. Now you can remove the pump itself. It takes a little bit of wiggling, but it's not too hard to get out. The new pump comes with a set of O-rings and an electrical adapter, in case your pump connector isn't the same as the original. Mine was the same, so I didn't need to use that. And don't forget to install your O-rings. The pump comes with a small gap or keyway that's meant to mate up with a tab on the washer tub itself. So there's only one way to put this pump in, but make sure that gap and tab line up before you start pushing it in. It's a pretty snug fit and takes a fair bit of wiggling to get it in, but when you're finished, try and make as small a gap as possible where that second O-ring meets the tub. Put the screws back into the retaining clip. This is what'll force the pump into position. Reinstall the power connector. It's a polarized connector, so it can only go in one way. Reinstall the check ball. Put the pump cover in position and screw it down. Reinstall the main filter and take note of the fact that drain spout going into the macerator of the pump can only go in one position. Reinstall the lower spray arm support and put the coarse filter back in place. Put the lower wash arm back in position. Plug the dishwasher back into mains power and slide it back into position, or at least within range of your drain line. Reattach the water supply line. And reattach your drain line. Be especially careful when putting this back on because the drain pump mounting tab is quite flimsy and I could see it getting broken off very easily. Now it should be safe to put your water supply valve back in the on position, allowing water to flow to the dishwasher again. Before you put the kick plate back on the bottom, put a towel down and sit there with a flashlight while you run the dishwasher through a cycle just to make sure you don't have any leaks. If you don't have any leaks, you're good to go. You're finished.